Hello and welcome. The graphics group under the results tab in Ansys Fluent enables the user to process the information contained in a CFD solution to visually analyze the simulation results. In this lesson, we will learn how to use graphics objects for the qualitative post-processing of a CFD simulation. This includes how to display mesh, contours, vectors, pathlines, and scene in the graphics window to examine the computational model and its solution. Additionally, we will explore options to hide or display graphics objects, disable color map, enable mirror view for symmetry boundaries, and different ways to share graphics objects from one Fluent session to another. Without any further delay, let's get started. Once a CFD simulation is set up and solved, we need to post-process the simulation to extract meaningful results. Qualitative post-processing refers to the use of graphical visualizations to analyze and understand the results of a CFD simulation. Different types of such techniques are grouped into the graphics group of the results tab in Ansys Fluent. In this lesson, we will be specifically discussing about mesh, contours, vectors, pathlines, and scene. Let's launch Ansys Fluent in solution mode and load an already simulated case to understand how to use the various post-processing techniques. The model simulates forced convection airflow over heated obstacles mounted in a channel with a symmetry boundary. Let's collapse some of the sections to make the graphics display area larger, as it makes it convenient while working with graphics. Now, navigate to the graphics group by clicking on the results tab in the ribbon and start by creating a mesh display object. Mesh plots allow us to visualize and inspect the computational mesh. We can plot mesh objects along with other post-processing objects to create powerful visualizations to understand the flow field. Click on mesh and click new. This opens the mesh display panel. Here, we have options to display mesh nodes, edges, faces of the geometry, partitions, and offset. When edges are selected, it will also display the mesh lines with additional options to display the whole mesh or only the outline or feature. Let's just show faces and select wall surfaces. The mesh display options also include shrinking the faces and cells in the display, selecting outline boundaries or interior surfaces in the surface list, identifying and displaying face zones that are adjacent to selected cell zones using adjacency and modifying the mesh colors. Most of these options are self-explanatory. For more details, please refer to the user's guide. Let's now click on Save Display. Notice that the object created appears under the tree in the outline view. In fact, all the objects we create will be listed here. We can hide the displayed objects by selecting and right-clicking the objects in the graphics window and then clicking on Hide Selected. To display objects, we can right-click in the graphics window, click Display and select the object to display, or we can also do this in the outline view just by right-clicking on the desired object and clicking Display from the context menu. Let's now talk about contour plots. Contour plots are a valuable post-processing tool that allows for the visualization of the distribution of a chosen variable in the flow field. Contour plots make use of color maps to represent the values of the specified field variable on the selected surfaces. There are multiple ways to create contours. We can either select the surface in the graphics window, right-click and navigate to Create, Contour, to open the contour panel, or click on Contours under Graphics Group in the ribbon and click New to open Contours panel. The panel has options to specify name and set various contour display options such as filled contours for continuous color display instead of just drawing lines representing specific values, node values, boundary values or contour lines to combine filled contours with line contours. Global range is used to base the minimum and maximum values on the range of values in the entire domain. Auto range is used to automatically determine the range of contour values. Clip to range allows us to clip the contour to areas where the variable values are within the desired range and draw mesh option to display the mesh. Using coloring option, we can also specify how contours appear. Banded contours feature distinct color bands corresponding to the color map, and smooth contours features a smooth transition between colors. The color map options allow us to customize the color map. Note that these options are common to other qualitative post-process objects like vectors, pathlines, and others. The contour panel has a list of scalar fields such as pressure, density, velocity, temperature, and much more from which we can choose the desired post-processing variable for visualization and a list of surfaces on which contours are to be drawn. For our case, let's create a temperature contour on wall objects, name it temp-wall-objects, uncheck global range so that it is easier to see the temperature variation on the chosen surface, and click Save Display. Here, we see the temperature distribution over the wall objects. To show where hotspots are formed, let's disable auto range and clip to range by entering the desired min and max values. Now, click Save Display. Let's switch gears and talk about another qualitative post-processing technique. In order to visualize and understand complex flow phenomena in our simulation, for example, to represent the flow around the obstacles, depicting details of the wake structure, the vectors graphics object can be used. Vector plots simply display a vector field using arrows whose color indicates the vector magnitude and the direction represents the vector direction. Vectors can be drawn in the entire domain or on selected surfaces. In this case, we are interested in the results on a plane normal to the y-axis that is not part of the actual mesh. For that, let's create the ZX plane from surface group, name it y-plane-obstacle, and position it such that it is passing through the center of the wall objects. For a detailed discussion on creating surfaces, please refer to our lesson on surfaces. Now click on Vectors under Graphics and click New. Select to color by velocity for the Y-plane obstacle surface. We can change the vector style and scale them. Note that the spacing, size, and coloring of the arrows can also be modified along with several other vector plot settings using vector options, and color map settings can be changed using color map options. Let's click Save Display. Notice the flow around the wall objects and the complex recirculation regions in the flow. Next, we will talk about pathlines. Pathlines are paths followed by individual, massless fluid particles from one point to another. They are a useful means of visualizing complex flows involving recirculation zones, zones of significant turbulence, etc. To create pathlines, click on Pathlines under Graphics and click New. Select color by particle variables and time in the sub-tab. Then release from inlet surface and click Save Display. The pathline plot can be difficult to understand because there are too many paths displayed. We can reduce the pathline density by increasing the path skip value. This makes it easy to visualize the flow around the wall objects. The Pathlines panel also has options to change pathline style, path style attributes, set step size or steps, and even coarsen pathlines. For a more detailed discussion, please refer to the user's guide. There may be cases where we want to display multiple post-processing objects at the same time in a single window. This can be done using Scene. Right-click in the graphics window and choose Create and then Scene. Now, let's overlay multiple graphics plots within a single graphics window and click Save and Display. Scenes also allow us to adjust transparency of each plot to emphasize a particular plot or view. The plot shows the hotspots on the wall objects along with velocity vectors and path lines depicting the flow field in the channel all at the same time. Notice that when a scene contains multiple objects that have color maps associated with them, all the color maps are displayed in the graphics window. To disable it, right-click on the desired object in the outline view and click Edit. Here, click on Color Map Options, uncheck Show Color Map in the Color Map panel and click Apply. To create a mirror view for a symmetry boundary, right-click on Graphics in the Outline view, click View, select Symmetry under Mirror Planes and click Apply. This shows results on the entire geometry. If we ever run into a situation where we have to share graphic objects from one Ansys Fluent session to another, this can be done in three different ways. First, we can right-click on the desired graphics object in the outline view, say Mesh, and click Copy to Clipboard, then navigate to another case, right-click on the same graphics object and click Paste. The second option is to use Export to File. Right-click on Contours and click Export to File, and then navigate to another case and click on Import from File. Lastly, we can simply drag it onto another case. Note that it is not allowed to copy graphics objects that are unlike. We can only transfer like objects to like objects. While doing this, it is important to make sure that the same surfaces are created in both the Ansys Fluent sessions, without which the copied graphics objects would be reported invalid in the outline view, as the surface list is empty in the session where it is copied to, and the graphic objects may not be the same in the new session. Let's summarize what we've learned in this lesson. We've learned how to perform qualitative post-processing operations for visualizing the solution data in Ansys Fluent using the graphics objects in the Results tab. We've learned how to display mesh, contours, vectors, and path lines. We've also learned how to overlap multiple graphics objects within a single graphics window using Scene and how to share graphics objects from one Ansys Fluent session to another. With that, let's wrap up the lesson.